So with this, maybe Dimitrios, let's go to Hong Kong. So you're working normally in the UK and now you're in Hong Kong, but you're a Greek and you just heard the praise for Greece doing the right thing. So from the academic point of view, how do you see, and I know Hong Kong Polytech is one of the universities at the forefront of new ideas and change, and certainly very much aware of intercultural differences. So what's your point on how to get these changes also into the education and into the minds of the next generation of people working in our industry?
Thank you, Wolfgang, and great to be with you, and fantastic to see Eduardo, and Eduardo covered a lot of the things I want to say. I'm currently away from Bournemouth University and sabbatical in Hong Kong Polytechnic University. So I'm having a global perspective, if you like, on what's happening with tourism and how COVID has affected people. And some of you will know that has affected me more than others because I lost my sister on COVID. And I think it's really, really important to actually start thinking about the situation that we've seen around the world with COVID. And I hear a lot of people pushing towards restarting tourism, but I think we need to be a little bit more careful. And coming into Hong Kong from the UK, I had 21 days of quarantine, hard quarantine in a hotel room, and I had 9 PCR tests in order to be released to the community. So this is the one extreme, if you like, the other extremes in different places. I think it's really critical to understand, and we've just started to understand how important tourism is. Because up to now, tourism was something, an activity that was happening in the background, and quite a lot of people were actually quite annoyed about tourism. And you mentioned, Wolfram, about over-tourism. As you know, I don't believe in over-tourism. I believe in badly managed tourism. I believe that tourism needs much more attention and needs much better planning, development, and support in order to bring benefits to communities. And what we've seen communities around the world, I was in the summertime, I was traveling in Greece because I wanted to support communities, and especially on the islands. Most of the islands were absolutely desperate. I was speaking to people and they were telling me the year before, in 2020, they had an incredibly difficult year and they were amazed that they survived the winter time. And I think we hear stories from Bali, we hear stories from Thailand, from Africa, in a lot of places where the animals do not have enough food to eat, because if the tourists are not there, they are not supporting feeding the animals, and the whole ecosystem is under difficulty. I think for the first time, we've got the level of government support on a global basis to understand how critical it is. And I think for the first time, we see consumers and tourists understanding how important tourism is for their mental health and their ability to see friends and relatives and their ability to survive in the future. Now, up to now, I think we are very guilty in looking tourism backwards. We have not really adopted the new practices. And we're still thinking about the tourism industry as a legacy industry, how it was happening 20 or 30 years ago. And I think there's several progressive operators that they are moving things forward. And when we are talking about how education is going to bring us benefits, I think, first of all, we need to start thinking about how research is going to bring us benefits and how we understand things in that detail and that granularity that will enable us to understand how we can generate transformational experiences and value for everybody who is involved in the tourism ecosystem. And once we understand that, we need to look into how technology and smart systems will take us forward to the next stage. I think we should not be looking to what jobs we had 10, 20 years ago, but what jobs we will need to have in 20 years ahead. and what skills we will need 20 years ahead. And we need to start looking to how can we prepare the industry for the next stage. Right now, there's a huge shortage of labor all over the world because a lot of people moved away from tourism and hospitality, and they started doing, because they couldn't find, they couldn't survive, they couldn't find work. And they went into logistics, they went to a lot of other industries. I think we need to start looking to what value do we need in the future, and then start thinking about what can we do to co-create this value with the young people. I'm very privileged to meet young people every day and see how passionate they are about this industry and how they would like to take things forward. But quite often they are very frustrated because they are not given the opportunities. I think it's critical that we understand that most of the jobs that people will do in 20 years' time will be very different to the jobs that they were doing 20 years ago. And I think we are all problematic in the sense that we have got a lot of legacy thinking. In my area, which is technology and smartness, GDSs, global distribution systems, are still dominating the industry. Yeah. And we've got a real difficulty in adopting the new innovative approaches to move things forward. I think this is a forum like the Global Tourism Forum should concentrate on that, bringing together the best brains in the industry and bring together the best expertise from research development to co-create the new realities that they're going to take us forward rather than look backward. And I don't want to hear people about talking about degrowth of tourism. I really want to talk about how we can make sure that the growth of tourism can be supportive of communities, can be sustainable, can be offering benefits to everybody who is on this ecosystem. And I think this is the challenge that we are having forward. And I think COVID gave us the opportunity to pause for a minute and create that knowledge and think about what we can do. I spent most of the 400 days of lockdown in England doing the Encyclopedia of Tourist Management and Marketing just to bring all this knowledge together. And we really need to engage with industry very closely, yes, and governments in order to be able to take this knowledge into the field and make sure that we can develop it for developing the benefits that tourism is bringing.